Hi friends, today I am giving a lecture on example problems on rule P, rule T and rule CP in discrete mathematics. So there are three types of inference rules are there. First one is rule P, second one is rule T, third one is rule CP. Okay, we go for example problem on rule P, rule T and rule CP. So show that R or S is logically valid from the following premises. So C or D conditional negation H, negation H conditional A and negation B, A and negation B conditional R or S. So these are the given premises. Okay. From these given premises, we have to show that R or S is valid conclusion or not. Okay. By using these three rules, rule P, rule T and rule CP. Okay. First one. Okay, C or D. First, we can take the premise C or D. So, this is statement number one. This is premise one. Okay, so this is rule P. Here, rule P is nothing but whenever a premise may be introduced in this derivation, then that rule is called as rule P. So, this premise is introduced into this derivation of deriving R or S. Okay. So that this premise may be introduced into the derivation. So this rule is called as rule P. Okay. Next, we can take another premise. This premise is also introduced into the derivation by using rule P. So this is second one, second premise. So, this is a statement number 2. So, C or D conditional negation H. Okay. So, by observing this, this is also a rule P. Because second premise may be introduced into the derivation. Okay. So, from these two premises, okay, by using any implication or equivalence rule, we are getting any new premise. Okay. So, here, this can be taken as P. So, this is also P. So, this is Q. Okay. According to the I-11 property, this is implication rule number 11. So that is P comma P to Q. So implies, so that is Q. So according to this rule, so P is C or D. So P comma P to Q, P conditional Q. What we are getting from this one? Q. From these two statements, C or D, C or D conditional negation H. From these two statements, we are getting negation H by using the rule number I-11. Okay. So, by combining these two statements, two premises, 1 comma 2, the statement number 3, we are getting negation H by using rule T. So, this is rule T. Rule T is occurred whenever from these two premises, we are getting the new premises, negation H. So, that rule is called as rule T. Rule T is applied on which statements? Statement number 1 and statement number 2. And the formula is I-11. Okay. Here, I-11 is P comma P to Q. Implies Q. So, this is the I-11 property, I-11 implication rule. Okay. So, next. Next, we can take another premise, this premise. Now, this is the fourth statement. So, this is also fourth statement. Okay, negation H, conditional A and negation B. Okay, so this premise may be introduced into the derivation by using rule P. Okay, so by observing these two premises, so this is called as P. So this is also called as P. This is also called as Q. Okay, P comma P to Q. Then we are getting, according to the implication rule I-11, we are getting the Q. Okay, by combining these two, 1 comma 2 comma 4, 1 comma 2 is negation H, 4 is negation H conditional A and negation B. By combining these two, we are getting 1 comma 2 comma 4. Next statement number is 5. We are getting P comma P to Q. We are getting A and negation B. Okay. So, this is a rule P from the statements, statement 3 and statement 4. And again I-11. So, here I-11 is P comma P to Q implies Q. Okay. Next, we can take another premise. This statement number is 6. So, here instead of 3, we are writing as 1 comma 2. So, instead of 5, by combining these two, we are getting 1 comma 2 comma 4. Next statement number is 6. So, this is also 6. What is the premise we are taking? A and negation B conditional R or S. So, this premise may be introduced into the derivation by using rule P. Okay. Next one. So, it can be taken as P. It can be taken also as P. It can be taken as Q. Suppose. Okay. Again, P comma P to Q. We are getting Q. Q is nothing but R or S. By combining these two, we are getting 1 comma, 2 comma, 4 comma, 6. New statement number 7, we are getting R union S. So, that is rule T. Statement number 5 and 6. 5 comma 6 and rule number I-11. So, what is I-11? So, I-11 is nothing but P comma P to Q. That implies Q. Okay. So, we are getting capital R or S. So, therefore, R or S is a logically valid conclusion from the given premises. Okay, now we go for, and here RRS is logically valid conclusion. By using these premises, we have to prove that RRS is a logically valid conclusion. Next, we go for another example problem.